chalk line down there in turn number four off of turn four. That's where our starter will start the race. Turning the caution lamp off, we're in it here. Green flag in the air. Wow, Tommy Curry gets a great start. TJ Reed must have spun as he gassed it up. Look at him fan out, two and three wide through the middle of one and two, three wide coming off of turn number two. Tommy Curry in the 4T, he is out front. Look at Derek Ellis in the 99, diving to the bottom in the inside of Kenny Collins. Two Georgia drivers there. Ellis on the bottom side in the 99 car. He'll move to third. Kenny Collins falls to fourth. Your transfer spot is the 9 car. That is Jason Croft. Jason Croft. Wolfenbarger to the inside. Little bit of door bing. Wolfenbarger to the 6th spot. You see the sparks coming off the brake. He wants more. Ashton Winger gets by now. He'll take the transfer spot. Watch back there between the 28, the 12, and the 9. That is your transfer spot. The 12 has it. Wolfenbarger wants it back. Tommy Kerr opens up about an 8-car length advantage over T.J. Reed. One goes around. Glenn Elliott can't miss him. It was the 12 of Ashton Winger. Spins. Almost had it corrected, but Glenn Elliott had nowhere to go. Winger in the bikes. Glenn Elliott back out on the speedway. He's going to rejoin the field. Dusty Carver makes a move to the bottom. Kenny Collins holds him off. Croft flies off of turn two. He'll get the transfer spot. Wolfenbarger going to dig down in. Almost score contact there. So now the 9 car, Jason Croft, has that transfer spot. The coveted transfer. Ligon got pitched out to the wall by Wolfenbarger. Croft trying to pick up another spot. He's on the tail of the 9 of Dusty Carver. He wants to put a little cushion in there. Speaking of cushion, he got pushed right down to the bottom of the speedway by Carver. White flag in the air for Tommy Kerr. The 9 cars are battling it out for the transfer position. Well, actually for the 5th position. Wolfenbarger making a last ditch effort. Can't make it happen. Tommy Kerr picks up the win, followed by Derek Ellis in the 99. TJ Reed in the 41. The 1C of Kenny Collins. Dusty Carver in the 9C. And Jason Croft in the 9 car. That is your last and final transfer position. Everyone else, save 2, will transfer to the trailer, unfortunately. And we will have 2 provisionals, so the drivers are asked to keep the headsets on, listen up. We'll announce it as soon as we have it for you. That will be announced at the completion of heat race number 2. 2 tunes.
Oh, shoot.
All righty. Dustin Linville in the 8D, Roger Biss in the 1G, getting ready to take the green flag in the American Racer Tire heat race number 2. Green flag, it wasn't a pretty one, but we'll go. Linville will lead him into 1, 2 and 3 wide at the bottom of turn 1. The 31 kind of got pushed out, and race director Kelly Carlton said, guys, you got to keep them tight there. Coming off of 4, we'll try it again. He's not wasting any time. He's telling them we're going back green this time. You see your flagman holding the field, holding the field, holding the field, and we'll be green flag. Best with a good start on the outside. Car shot a little sideways. He's going to dig it down to the inside. Right up against the inside berm is the 1G of Roger Best. Aaron Ridley will shoot by on the inside. The 31 car of Nick Latham also trying the inside. Rambo there, well, he's trying to work his way into the top 6. I believe he may have had it that time by But Jeremy Hines in the 5H has your transfer spot. Rambo picks off 1, 2, 3 down the back straightaway. Rambo in that red number 2 car. He's made his way up to fourth looking for more. Dustin Linville out front. Aaron Ridley, the 81 second. Roger Best in the 1G third. Dennis Rambo Franklin, the 2 car. Robbie Moses, the 21M. And Jeremy Hines in the 5H. That's your transfer. Hines up top. He digs it down low, trying to work to the inside of Moses. He wants more. The 31 of Nick Latham, he's working up the top side. He wants to get in this main event. He's a long way from home. Latham, the Indiana Riley, he works into the transfer spot. Latham to the transfer spot in the 31 machine. Hines going to work back to his outside. But Latham, good bite off of turn two at the bottom. He has Moses in front of him. Great battle for that transfer spot. Watch it there. All the while back out front, Dustin Nimble holding a nice lead. 2-3 car lengths over Aaron Ridley. We got the 2X of Anthony White, pulls it pit side. It's still Latham in the 31. He has the transfer. He takes it up. He moves to the fifth spot. That moves the transfer spot back to Robbie Moses. White flag in the air. Latham, he's picked up about 4 car lengths over Moses. Moses in the 21. He's got the transfer spot. Hines way loose there in turn 1 and 2. He's going to dig it down hard. Going to go topside through 3 and 4. Can he hang on to it? Coming to the line. Moses will hang on in the 21 for your transfer position. Dustin Linville picks up the win. Aaron Ridley second. Roger Best in the 1G. Dennis Franklin the 2. Nick Latham in the 31. And Robbie Moses in the 21 picks up the final transfer position. We'll give you the 2 provisionals in just a few moments. Woo, those are 2 good ones there for our heat races in the Ultimate Series. We'll be back for the main event. 40 laps, $5,000 on the line here very shortly. Well, we're going to interrupt you because they're coming at us full on for the Ultimate Supers. $5,000 to win, getting ready to roll. Glenn Elliott in the 5 car. He'll be one of our provisionals. Starting shotgun on the field. Then it's Bobby Giffen in the 97. Row number 11, the 21 of Robbie Moses. Jason Croft in the 9. Row 10, Nick Latham in the 31. Dusty Carver, the 9 car. Rambo, Dennis Franklin in the 2. He will start outside row number 9. To his inside, Kenny Collins in the 1C. Roger Best in the 1G. He will start row number 8. To his inside, 41 TR. I know what you're doing. Aaron Ridley in the 81 will be outside row 7. To the inside, Derek Ellis in the 99. Dusty Linville in the D8. To his inside will be the 4T of Tommy Kerr, your top 10. Shannon Buckingham in the 21 car. Corey Hedgecock, the 23. In the 8th position will be Mac McCarter in the 51. Riley Hickman in the R1 will start 7th. Starting 6th will be the 52D of Mark Douglas. Chris Ferguson in the 22 will be to his inside. He will start 5th. Vic Hill in the 1 will start 4th. Casey Roberts, the 101, starts 3rd. Your front row, Dylan Ames in the 77. And your pole sitter, Donald McIntosh in the 7 car. We are ready to go racing fans here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. My pleasure to bring you the action once again. 40 laps, $5,000 on the line for these Ultimate Supers. Off of turn 4, waiting for the green flag. Here we go! McIntosh out front, feeling under the weather, but he'll take it down to turn 1. McIntosh, Roberts, Ames, and Ferguson up to the 4th position. Watch him two and three wide throughout the field. Ferguson, he'll move to the third spot underneath Dylan Ames. Roberts loses a little ground through the middle of one and two. McIntosh has that in figured out. Rambo on a tail moving towards the front. Watch the bottom three, three and four. Riley Hickman picks up a spot. He'll move to fourth. Rambo Dennis Franklin started 18th. He is already to the 11th position and looking for more. Back out front, though, it's McIntosh, Roberts, Ferguson, Hickman, Ames, Kerr, Hedgecock, Ellis, Hill, and Collins. That's your top 10. Rambo working that bottom side. He works to the inside of Kenny Collins. Casey Roberts starting to draw in on Donald McIntosh now. It's just a two-car length advantage. Ferguson keeping them right there in their sights. They're working the bottom into Speedway through one and two. Side by side for the lead out the field, but Roberts slows. What's he got right beside McIntosh? Possibly problems on the 101. McIntosh already caught the tail of the field. Tough break for Casey Roberts. He pulls it pit side. The 52 of Douglas goes pit side. Tough break for your 2015 points champion, Casey Roberts. He pulled it pit side. McIntosh already in traffic. Ferguson looking to the inside. He's got it within a car length, going to the rear bumper. All trying to force the issue. Careful there, gentlemen. They're three wide as McIntosh trying to be the Oreo. The cream in the Oreo, I should say. Ferguson trying to work even lower. Almost got up on that inside berm. What a battle out front. And look at the R1 of Riley Hickman. He's trying to join in. Side by side for the lead. Ferguson to the bottom. Holy cow. Ferguson gets to the inside. They spin. Riley Hickman goes up. McIntosh stays outside and he stays green. Ferguson. Ultimate Super Late Model Series, by the way. It's on the outside. Here we go. Green flag in the air. Clean down to turn one. Derek Ellis in the 99 car. He took a peek inside Tommy Kerr for the fourth position. Look on the outside, Corey Hedgecock trying to make some moves up there. Vic Hill also up on the top side. He's one that makes it work on the top side here. Aaron Ridley has crossed over. He looks to the bottom, trying to work underneath the 1C of Kenny Collins. Collins up to the seventh position. Collins starting in the 17th position. He's up to seventh. McIntosh, he stretched that lead up to a 1.5 second advantage over Dylan Ames. Riley Hickman has slid back a couple spots. He's gone back to fifth. Maybe a little bit more than sheet metal damage. Ferguson in the 22 car back up to 15th. He's going to work hard to work his way back towards the front. The 9 car, Dusty Carver, is pulled to the infield. Lap number 19 in the books as McIntosh flashes by. He's up to a 3-second advantage over Dylan Ames. Working off of turn four, McIntosh will pass the cross flags. Halfway down, halfway to go. That one slowing on the top of turn two. I believe that's Mac McCarter. Mac McCarter slowing down the back straightaway. Caution on the speedway. McIntosh did not want to see the caution. Everybody, I believe he's just making a change, trying to make some traction. Back to 13th. Hadn't lost any, still on the lead lap. Here we go, green flag back in the air. McIntosh will lead him back one. Riley Hickman up on the top side, going to try to work. Aaron Ridley onto the inside. Aaron Ridley goes to the fourth spot. Derek Ellis back to fifth. The 31 car of Nick Latham, he may have a flat left rear. I'm betting a flat left rear on the, oh yeah. It's not flat, it's just about shredded. Latham. Nick Latham. Nick Latham in the 31 car. The green flag fly. Green in the air, and it's McIntosh will lead him down. Curl move to second. The teammate, but Ames works it back underneath. Drag race down the back straightaway. Ames will lead it. Between the second and third place runner. But it's McIntosh already picking up almost a second advantage in one lap. Only side-by-side battle right this moment is between Dustin Limbo and T.J. Reed. Reed takes the spot. T.J. Reed, the 41 car, he's on your move. He just worked to the outside of Derek Ellis. Ellis able to work back underneath in one and two. The Reed, one of the few guys stepping up on the top on the turn three and four side of the speedway. You're going to have to go where the other guys aren't. Glenn Elliott in the five car makes a move. He'll pick up his position. Wait, that's over Dustin Limbo. Elliott up to the 11th position. Ferguson has made his way back into the top 10. The 97 Bobby Geffen slow in turns three and four. Caution on the speedway. And he gasses her up. We're back. Green flag racing. Tommy Kerr, good jump on the outside. He dives down to the inside, going to try to hold off. Dylan Ames got a great battle there for the fourth position, and they're two by two down the back straightaway. Derek Ellis right up, all the way up on the bottom, trying to work to the inside of Corey Hedgecock. He gets pushed out. Now Kenny Collins will take advantage. He works to the inside of Derek Ellis for that sixth position. McIntosh likes to see his teammate right there in the second spot. Gives him a little extra breathing room. for the fifth position. Sixth position, Kenny Collins working to the inside of TJ Reed. Reed works it up high. He likes the high side. Kenny Collins right down the bottom. They come off this turn side by side, but the outside momentum gets you down the straightaway. McIntosh, if you can hear him down the front straightaway, he's backing off at the flag stand. Carr handling perfectly. He's built up a 2.5 second advantage. Field kind of settled in for a few laps here. All right, for turn four. McIntosh will see a hand outstretched. 5 laps to go for Donald McIntosh. Working lap 36 coming to the flag stand will work 37. It's R.O. McIntosh. He has a almost four second advantage, a straightaway over his teammate Tommy Kerr. McIntosh leads him down to turn one. See, he wasn't feeling well early. I bet he's going to feel good here in just a moment as he works a 4 second advantage off of turn four. Donald McIntosh picking up his third Ultimate Super victory here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. His teammate Tommy Kerr finishes second, and Dylan Ames will bring it home third. Aaron Ridley fourth, Corey Hedgecock fifth, and TJ Reed sixth.
All right. Donald said he was feeling a little rough earlier. Team came up and confirmed it, said to step away. Look out, let him get on his all his little swag here, Schaefer's Racing Lubricants. Who's your race tire swag? Donald McIntosh climbing out of the machine. Give him a hand, folks. Donald McIntosh, that wasn't a real big win. I hope this win makes you feel a little better, though, sir.
Man, this is so awesome. To be able to get this for Larry Garner and the team, as awful as I have run here, I don't feel that great, but man, this is just so awesome. I'm really not taking it in as much as I should because I don't feel that great, but man, this is awesome. For all these teams to put this car back together as many times as I've tore it up here to be able to come out with a win. I can't thank Vic Hill Race Engines enough. We had awesome power all night long. Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, Stowers Cat. Man, this is so awesome. And for Tommy to come in second, this is just it's just cool, man. Awesome.
Third win on Ultimate Tour. Man, if you were feeling good, how much would you have won by? I don't know, man.
I don't think it'd been any different. This car is just awesome, and we're getting our changes figured out on it. It's a lot different than what we've been used to, but man, just awesome day for us.
Congratulations. Donald McIntosh picking up $5,000 here at Smoky Mountain Speedway, getting the big trophy check from Miss Ultimate, Miss Megan O'Shields. We're going to go over here and speak to his teammate, Tommy Kerr. Tommy? Great restart there, that last restart. Mate, you tried that high side move several times, but that time you got hooked up and dove it to the bottom, able to hold him off.
Yeah, I kept working under caution trying to clean the marbles and stuff up, and I thought I had them cleaned up at one time and didn't, and got back in line, and that last time I got it cleaned up. So, I mean, that was a terrific run starting 11th. Congratulations to Donald, the whole Blunt Motorsports team. You know, I'm out here having fun. That was fun tonight.
Fun it was. It looked fun. And I could see you on those restart, on those caution laps, really working that top side, trying to iron it back in. And that's what it pays off at, doesn't it?
Yeah, you just, there's little old gritty dirt up there on the top of the black. And, I mean, if you hit it and it's laying there, it's like you're on glass. But we just kept cleaning it up where I could get a good run, especially on the restart up here. I couldn't accelerate with Donald or him because of the marbles up there on the outside. But we, all in all, we had a good run, enjoyed ourselves, and we'll be back down here in a few weeks.
Congratulations so much, Tommy. Take care. And we're going to go talk to Dylan Ames, get this third place, man. Dylan, sir, great run for you as well, starting front row. Last caution there. Tommy got you from the high side. But, man, what a great run for your team.
Yeah, we had a good car. I'd like to thank, first of all, my mom and dad for doing this for me and supporting me. And really like to thank Marshall Green and Shane Clanton and Capital Race Cars for all the support. And R2C Air Filters and Jay Dickens for providing us with an awesome power plant.
I tell you what, running with these guys and running third has to be a great feeling.
Oh, yeah, it is. We've had some good runs. We hadn't run here much. This is our best finish here. We're happy with it.
Congratulations, Dylan Ames, your third place finisher here at Smoky Mountain Speedway tonight.